The first garden was established in 1916. At that time, it was called Shakespeare Garden. Now it's called the British Garden. And a visiting dignitary from India, Sir Rabindranath Tagore, planted an ivy at this garden. We don't know whether the ivy has survived, but certainly the plaque commemorating this event saying Sir Rabindranath Tagore came to this spot and planted this ivy, that still survives and it can be seen in the British Garden. Sir Rabindranath Tagore. Those of you who are students of Indian history would of course know that Tagore later returned the Sir, the knighthood, to protest the Jallianwala Bagh massacre. In the ensuing decade, only one additional garden came in, that was Hebrew Garden. That was led by Leo Weidenthal, and in about 1927, the Hebrew Garden got established. After that, the process was slow and desultory. In the 1970s, when the Indian community was gathering numbers and prestige, the people involved with the community at that time, people involved with FICA at the time, such as Dr. Bafna and Paramjit Singh and others, got a special dispensation from the city of Cleveland. And this city of Cleveland in 1979 allocated a specific spot to Indian community, and that is today what we understand to be India Community Garden. Now, after that, there was a lot of talk, but the lead at that time was taken by the young community. Dr. Haria's daughter, Seema Haria, and her friends from Case Western Reserve University performed the first groundbreaking ceremony to commemorate the 50th anniversary of India's independence. So this happened on August 15, 1997. So that we can say is India Cultural Garden's birthday. Then by 2002, the efforts had reached a point where a special committee called India Cultural Garden Committee was established within FICA to come up with a multi-phase vision of what the garden would look like and do the corresponding amount of fundraising. The committee was greatly helped by the late, great Vijaya Imani, also Raj Pillai and Ramesh Mirakur. Many of you may not know that Ramesh now lives in India, but has come all this way to be at this event. The vision was in three parts. One element was the tallest statue of Mahatma Gandhi. It is still the tallest statue of Mahatma Gandhi in the United States. The second was beautifully arranged six legacy pillars. These pillars would not only commemorate the past, but also show the aspirations of modern India. And the third phase was to include the Sanchi Stupa Gate replica, which is the oldest stone structure standing in the world, and also steps going down to the Don Brook, because the idea of a ghat or panaghat is deeply embedded in the Indian culture and psyche. In 2006, the Mahatma Gandhi statue was unveiled. This statue was made possible by substantial contribution from two families, Chittaranjan and Nisha Jain, and Ashok and Rajni Shendure. The following year, six legacy pillars were dedicated, and they were sponsored by, in the alphabetical order, the Ahuja family, the Bafna family, the Fotedar family, the Haria family, the Pillai family, and the Sathe family. We say to all these families once again, thank you, we cherish your gift, and we want to honor them with a really big round of applause. Now on the 10th anniversary, we are ready to embark on the next and the final phase of this garden.